I started the Codify 7 months back, and it's to basically help developers debug their websites, and some of the customers. I don't think let's skip this stage. So what is the Codify? It's like Google Analytics for web developers. And what's the need for this kind of a product? So let's start. Let's see how web is evolving. 2 years back, we have this kind of a Gmail. Now it's this kind of a Gmail. Like all the things are moving from server side running code to more of client side to JavaScript driven code. And so, and as you can see, browsers have evolved a lot in the last 2-3 years. Like over the time, you can see like Chrome has a lot of releases in the last 1-2 years. So as browsers are evolving, a lot of code breaks in JavaScript because all browsers have different APIs for the same functions and different implementations, which can lead to a lot of problems for developers. I think almost every one of us has faced similar issues. So, and when code breaks, mostly users get frustrated. And when users get frustrated, they call support and they make them frustrated. And now time for developers to get frustrated. So this is something like for any product, like you release a product, you test it thoroughly, and next week or something, some browser upgrades, some library upgrades, your code eventually breaks, and most of the time you don't know, because most of the testing you have done is of no use, like of not that much use. So, and even when something breaks, you're not aware of that, because mostly of the problems are error information is captured in the browsers, and developers don't have access to much of the browsers and standard way of getting that information to the servers. So this is where, and even you get the information, even after that, you have to answer a lot of questions, like when did the problem happen, how many users are facing it, and what's the exact file it happens, and not many questions even you start to fix that problem. So how Debugify helps is basically it's capture all the information and it collects in one central dashboard. So where you can log into that dashboard and see what's going on. So just in the dashboard overview. So first thing, it tells you like if you have let's say 100 users, it can directly tell you that this problem is faced by 72 users or 10% of your user base. So you can easily understand that this is the target. This is a small problem or this is a big problem. This, how is affect your business or how it affect your product usage, and this about affected users. Second thing is a very common thing, like user agent distribution. You can easily see like a problems, the same problem happens on which versions of the browsers or which different kind of operating systems. And okay. So third thing is what different kind of messages you want to, like sometimes you want to catch errors and sometimes you want to catch a lot different kind of information like warnings and maybe logs. For debugging our JavaScript side code, just like server side, we don't have a standard way of doing it for JavaScript code. Next thing is like how the data is viewed. So this is you can see like uncaught reference error, Google is not defined. This is an error. This happens in Chrome 23rd version on iOS. This is just like logs you see in a normal server side tool. And next thing is the detailed information of this any message. Like we can extend this message to the whole details. The details are currently focusing on specifying which user is specifically getting the problem. So you can pinpoint a specific user and know that this is the user. You can see the whole history of the user, that in the last 2 days or in the last 1 month, the user has faced this many problems. And the file names and the file path, the general debugging information. And the page, on which page the problem happens, what was the refer of the page. You can even do modularized logging with it. If you want to, let's say you have 10 modules, you want to do different log for different modules, you can easily kind of sort out things when you are searching in basically finding your problem in the whole bunch of thousands of logs you collected. And the geo information, where the user come from, all the GeoIP related information. And a lot more about the browser of the user facing the problem, like Java is supported, cookies are enabled or not, and a lot many features. And apart from that, what happens when you collect a lot of data? So the problem comes is like on a normal day, you collect 2,000, 3,000 errors. So it's not human possible to get through each error log. So you have need kind of intelligence to understand that whole collected information and give you an overview that this is the problem. You have to prioritize this problem first. Like you can see that this problem is jsvidal.net caught this error. This happened to 31 times. So this can be a higher priority as compared to other things. So this is trying to give you, intelligently tell you that prioritize your problem, check out this problem first rather than other problems. And so you can get some mental peace out of the product. So how to use it? It's so simple. Just put this code in your website and you are done. So some alternatives way of using this product is you can use a Chrome extension, you can use a WordPress plugin if you have a WordPress blog. So this is some rough figure for the last month, like I don't think 3,66,000 unique users, page views. So this is a use case for a company named Akosha.com. In 24 hours they captured like 5,002 errors. 733 users affected for them out of total 1,347 users. These are the distribution of the different browsers the users coming from and operating systems. So this is all I have built up till now, so I'm planning to extend this to server-side languages and give a full stack debugging kind of features so users can, like, especially full stack developers can get most benefit out of it. Question and answers. I think I have done.
How does it work? Can you report the stack?
Yeah, like I'm currently working to, like, browsers have problems, like Windows.on error doesn't provide much stack information, but I'm trying to put in some features to get stack most of the time. Like, it's not 100%, but it will improve with time.
What do you suggest you should do when you have a compressed minified JS?
So source map is one of the thing which will evolve, and I think with in future we will have good solutions for that, for minified code.
What is the performance effect on the user?
So performance effect is as of like if errors are not happening, like the code is once loaded, it's kind of a silent mode, it doesn't do anything until something breaks off or something like that.
No, is it like...
It's not a polling thing. It's kind of a listener. Something hit the listener, then it will work.
So it's totally
async kind of thing.
So how are you thinking of that server side you are talking about?
So, like, the whole idea is, like, normally we use 2-3 tools, one for server side and one for front end. So, like, and to bundle all the things in one dashboard so you can easily search out everything in one dashboard and relate things also, like, you have a one request response kind of a thing, right? So, you want to relate the front end error with the back end error in a whole cycle. So you can easily see that this things happens. I'm trying to do that thing. That's the idea I'm trying to work on.
Is there any other context that I can get, like what happened before this error? Like what are the pages the user visited?
Well, I think for that you have to do manual logging, like you can add some information, like something happens, you can, developer have to put some logic in there, so that can be tracked. But automatically, I don't, right, not right now, maybe in the future.
For
server
side, the large tools available.
Yes.
Like,
yes.
For example.
So Neuralink has done performance monitoring, as I know.
No, but they have this error. I don't know how in-depth it is. So there is something that we say.
So like
AirBrake does the same thing.
AirBrake. Someone bought it, right?
There are a few AirBrake get exceptional. There is Honeybatch.
There are plenty of companies trying to, like, I think it's a new space and like plenty of companies, I think, even in, I think he's also, Rakesh is also there, right? So like plenty of people trying to solve the problem, and problem is big enough, and I think there's plenty of things can be done around it, and plenty of good things can be done, so stop that.
So does your thing work for Node.js?
Node.js, not right now, but in future it will be. It's currently, in browser environments as well.
Thanks, Sankur.
one more thing, please try out the product and give me some feedback.
Yes, sure.
Site is debugify.net.